Welcome everyone, just a quick insider as to what I've been doing today. So one of the things I've been working on for Sol is a switch for his prosthesis. In the original version of Sol's arm, we had an actual momentary switch. There are two springs inside here. So that would turn it one way and push the button on the other side, turn it the other way, take your finger off, and it just stops. And unfortunately the spring was too powerful, so Sol had to push really hard on it, and that would mean that he's moving his arm around, and what you want is quite light operation. So what I decided to do is then switch that for a tiny little double pole, double throw switch, like so, if you can see. This is one that I tried to solder earlier and one of the connections came off because I'm not that good. So that goes inside, locks in place, leaving this appearance. So it had a big space here and it seemed only fitting really to stick the logo there. The entire thing before was the switch plate, but now it was just a big grey plate. Because of the way these are wired in, I had a big space. So what I've actually done there is just done 1mm rebate for the Ambionics logo, and then printed in colour fab VarioShore. Printed it so that it was foaming and went really, really white using the natural, and just pushed that inside. A little bit of super glue on the back, and yeah. Now, once that's in position, it just locks, so there's no backlash whatsoever. So it's a harmonic drive, so you can't force it back the wrong way. But it can be adjusted very easily using the switch. Next upgrade will be to improve the motor. So we'll take away the little DC gearbox motor, Mickey Mouse motor, and swap it for something more substantial. There's plenty of scope here to increase weight, and likewise, I'm going to put the battery inside the arm. So I found some radio-controlled 3.7 volts, I think, 1000 milliamp or 1100 milliamp hours LiPol batteries. So they could be wired in series. Check that that's right. Wired in series to give me the voltage that I need to operate the gearbox. So yeah, if it's inside, we'll have a charging point on the back and possibly a kill switch. And then we're ready to go. So the next step then will be to start to introduce control using EMG sensors that are going to be mounted here and here, and that way we should be able to, with the help of our university partners, be able to control the wrist using linear control. So Sol wants to turn it quickly, he can give a big strong signal and that will turn the wrist in one direction very quickly. Doesn't do anything, no signal, it'll stop. And likewise a big spike signal to turn the opposite direction from the other sensor, and then modulating it between 3 and 12 volts. That'll change the speed and power that we can use it. Very ambitious, but it's never been done, and I think it'd be much more useful than a multi-articulated hand. Right then, thank you very much for watching, and as usual, like, subscribe, leave a comment in the comments. If you want to find out more, feel free to ask. I can't show you the exact design of the harmonic drive at the moment, but my aim is, once it's commercialized, it'll be open source for everyone to use. But I have a dastardly plan to raise money for Ambionics using the gearbox in another application. If you want to find out more about that, then sign up for our newsletter. So again, in the first comment pinned below, there's going to be a link there to the Ambionics monthly newsletter, and in there we'll reveal details of competitions, giveaways, and so on. So if you love what we're doing, don't just loiter around and not subscribe. We know that most of our watchers and people who view our videos are not subscribed. Come and join the club, subscribe, you're welcome to join, and we'd love to see you in our monthly newsletter. Sol, anything you'd like to say?
Like and subscribe, guys!